Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, I'm going to explain what attribution is and outline the different attribution models you can use in Google Analytics. I'll also show you how you can find and apply the attribution models in your Google Analytics reports, including Google Analytics 4, GA4, and Universal Analytics. Okay, let's get started. The attribution reports in Google Analytics help you understand how people engage with your different marketing channels before they convert. And there are options that let you control how each of those different marketing touchpoints receives credit after the conversion occurred. For example, if someone found your website by clicking on an ad and then returned to your website via an organic search result before converting. In this case, which touchpoint should receive the credit for the conversion? The ad, the organic search result, or both? The attribution reports help you to understand this path to conversion, and you can apply and compare different attribution models in Google Analytics. So let's take a look at the different standard attribution models. First is the last click model. As the name suggests, this model gives all of the credit to the final click or touch point leading to a conversion. Then we have the first click model. This is where all of the credit goes to the first touch point. It's important to understand that this will vary depending on the lookback window. The lookback window controls how much historical data Google Analytics should consider when a conversion occurs. So this will impact the results you see for the first click attribution model. The other important thing to consider is the lead time for people converting on your website. If you expect a longer lead time, then using this model probably isn't going to be very helpful. Next is the linear attribution model. This is the first model we're looking at that makes use of multi or mixed attribution, or in other words, where we split credit across multiple touch points. The linear model is simple. Credit is evenly divided across all of the different touch points used to find your website that lead to the conversion. Next is time decay, which gives more credit to the final or most recent touch point. And then credit diminishes the further back in time we go. The model uses a 7-day half-life, which means that if we had a conversion today, then that touch point would receive credit, and the touch point 7 days ago would receive half of the amount of credit from today's touch point. Then there is the position-based model. This attribution model gives 40% credit to the first touch point, 40% credit to the final or last touch point, and the remaining 20% of the credit is divided evenly between the middle touch points. Next is Google Ads last click. This is very similar to the last click attribution model, but if there is a touch point from Google Ads in the path to conversion, then Google Ads will receive full credit for the conversion. I also wanted to mention there are a couple of differences depending on the version of Google Analytics you're using. If you're using Universal Analytics, then there are two last click attribution models, one that is called last interaction and another called last non-direct interaction. The last interaction model will give credit to direct if it's the final touch point. If you're using Google Analytics 4, GA4, then the last click attribution model will ignore direct traffic for the final touch point. Now that we've covered the models, let's take a look at the attribution reports available in Google Analytics. Let's start with Google Analytics 4, GA4. To find the attribution reports, we select Advertising from the menu on the left. And let's open the Model Comparison Report. The report lists our marketing channels on the left, and moving to the right, we can see the number of conversions and the revenue for each channel. These metrics are reported twice. The first set of metrics use the last click attribution model, and the second set of metrics use the linear attribution model. So the report allows us to compare how credit is given to our marketing touch points based on these two different models. On the very right of the report, we can then see the difference between the two models, so we can see the percentage increase and decrease when we compare them. And we can also change the attribution models we are comparing in the report. To do this, we can select a new model from the drop-down. So let's change linear to time decay. To use the report, we want to look for significant changes between the models. Changes that have a positive percent mean that we're potentially undervaluing the marketing channel when we use the last click model. And a negative percent tells us that we're potentially overvaluing a marketing channel when we use the last click model. The next report is the Conversion Paths report. This report provides a visual representation of the marketing touch points people engage with before converting. I need to highlight that the attribution reports in GA4 only include data from mid-June 2021, so you might need to wait until there is more information collected before the reports become really useful. Now that we've looked at the reports in GA4, let's take a look at the reports in Universal Analytics. To find the attribution reports in Universal Analytics, we need to select Conversions and then Multi-Channel Funnels. We can now see a number of attribution reports, including the Overview Report, Assisted Conversions, Top Conversion Paths, Time Lag, Path Length, and the Model Comparison Tool. Let's open the Top Conversion Paths report. This report is similar to the Conversion Paths report we saw in GA4. It provides a visual representation of the different touch points people use to find our website. At the top, you can choose the conversion actions that are used for the report, along with the path length, lookback window, and more. And if we open the Model Comparison tool, this is similar to the model comparison report in GA4. It lets us compare attribution models to see the impact on the way we're giving credit to our marketing channels. If you're using this tool in Universal Analytics, then I recommend you start by changing the first model to last non-direct click, so that it reflects what you see in the standard reports. You can then select additional models to view the comparison. And you'll also see an option to create your own custom models in Universal Analytics. So that's how you can use the attribution reports and the standard attribution models inside Google Analytics. Remember, there are some slight differences between the models you'll find in GA4 compared to Universal Analytics. And GA4 also lets you adjust the model used for your standard reports, while Universal Analytics uses the last non-direct click model for all of the standard reports. Are you using the attribution reports in Google Analytics? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, then please like it so I know to make more videos like this. See you in the next video.